Hey guys, welcome back to Handmade Home. I'm Hester and today I have a fun outdoor game for you. If you are in need of a bit of DIY inspiration, you can of course come to my website, but did you also know you can go to the Bosch website? In the All About DIY section there are so many lovely project ideas. There are bits of furniture you can make or decorative items, but they also have some really fun games. And I saw this ring tossing game and I thought it would be so much fun to have in the back garden. Only thing is though, I can only make it from materials I already have in the shed. I don't want to go shopping because of the lockdowns, but I think there's enough timber in there to see if I can make this ring tossing game. And no, for sure I don't have any rope, so it's gonna see what I can use instead to make the rings. But yeah, come and have a look and see how to make a ring tossing game. So if you're on the Bosch website and you click All About DIY, this is amazing project ideas, lots of tutorials, inspiration, things you can make. And I spotted this ring tossing game, I thought it looked so much fun. So I had a look in the shed to see what timber I had and I found these pellet wood planks. So instead of plain timber, we're going to use pellet wood planks and all the little bits I have left over to make the game. So the tools we need for this build. I'm using the Bosch Advanced Cut 18 Cordless Nano Blade Saw. It's an amazing little saw this, because you can use it to cut branches like this, but also to cut straight lines. And it's so tiny! Then I'm using the Bosch PSM 18 cordless sander and advanced drill. And both these all use the same battery. It's so handy. Then we're gonna need a pencil, a 12mm wood drill bit, and a measuring tape. With your planks, make sure they're all the same width, because you never know a pellet wood. These are all perfect the same size. So I'm just gonna measure them. We're gonna need two planks that are 80cm. Gonna measure, make a straight line, and then we're gonna cut. We need to calculate how big the smaller pieces need to be. So we need to know the width of these planks. So these are 9.5cm. Now we're gonna do 9.5 divided by 2. And we're gonna have to take this measurement of half the size of the planks, so of the 40. So I need to cut 4 pieces that are 35.25cm. Gonna measure these and cut them to size. The great thing about the little saw is it doesn't cause any vibration, so I don't need to clamp anything when I cut it. It's so quick to work with. Then we're gonna sand all the planks smooth, and as you can see my camera stopped working here. We are just imagine me just sanding all the planks. So here are the planks all cut, and we're gonna do the smaller pieces are gonna sit on the outer corners of the big piece, so the other one can slot right in. Apply wood glue, make sure the ends line up really perfectly so we have a 9.5cm gap in the middle where the other plank is gonna slot in. We're gonna keep this in place with some nails, around 3 nails per plank will do. Do the same with the other planks, and now we have 2 pieces that slot in perfectly to create a cross we need for our game. You can see the little lady came out, just do a bit of quality control just to check if my measurements were actually correct. I think she agrees, so now we can move on to drilling some holes. Let's move the battery over from the sander into the drill, and we're gonna drill 12mm wide holes around 4cm from the edge in the middle of the plank. We're gonna do this on every outer corner of your plank, as you can see here. And we're also gonna do it in the middle, and also in the middle of the inner piece it's gonna sit in. Let's give the holes and the plank a final sand, make sure it's all nice and smooth, and it's time to cut our dowel. I found this piece of 12mm thick dowel in my shed, and it's the only piece I have, so we're just gonna see how long it is and divide this by 5. My bits ended up being 18cm. I'm gonna cut these to size, give them a little sand, and our toys ready to put together. And as you can see, you can just fold it together, and you put the dowels in, and that's your toy made. We're also gonna need some numbers there, because of course you wanna get points when you play this game. And I just went with a Sharpie. You can do this with decals, with stickers, but I thought Sharpie is just as easy. And I did the numbers 5, 10, 15, 20, and 25. Now we just need to make the rings. And as I said before, I didn't have any rope, so I have to make my own rope. I'm using this spaghetti yarn from Hooked. It's like a jersey thick yarn. And what I did, I took 5 strands of 80cm, and I did 4 blue ones and 1 neon yellow, as why not. We're gonna tie these together, just a bit of extra little yarn, tie them at the top. And now we're gonna twist it together to make our own rope. And this is so much easier than you think it's gonna be. So all you need to do now, you have to divide them in 3 strands and 2 strands. And what you're gonna do, you're gonna twist them away from you. So around your finger, you're gonna twist twice. And you're gonna bring it forward towards you. And you're gonna do the same thing with the other strands. take it around your finger, you're gonna twist it twice away from you, away from your body, and then put it towards you over the other rope. As you can see, my thumb is holding it down quite tightly here. So you're gonna get your yarn, twist it away from you twice, pull it forward towards you, and then put your thumb on top. And just keep doing this until you have around 40 centimeters of rope, then we can make a nice little ring. Keep twisting away from you, and then pull it forward towards you. So away, over, away, over, and keep doing this until, as you can see, you've got a nice bit of rope. What we're gonna do now, we're just gonna tie this together. So we're just gonna split it here and tie it around the original knot we made. Make sure it's really nice and secure. Do a good knot. And then we're just gonna, for a bit of extra security, I'm just gonna tie a few other pieces together. Just a few little strands, some random ones. I'm just gonna tie them together in a really tight knot. When you think everything is nice and secure, you can snip away the extra bit of yarn. There you have it, our own homemade little rope rings. Of course I made a few more, because I need around 5 to play this game, and I made them all different colors. Now let's go outside and play this game. Especially as I was following the tutorial on the Bosch website on the All About DIY section. There's so many good ideas on there, you should really go have a look. And I could use what I already had in the shed, which is a win-win. I got a really lovely game now to play with the family in the garden. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a big thumbs up and have a look at all the other videos here on the Handmade Home channel. I'll be back soon with a new video, and I really hope to see you then.